As Don mentioned, we had over 170 updates to choose from. So we've grouped the highlights into four different categories here. The first category of ignition that we're going to talk about today is visualization. And more specifically, it's the ability to more easily and dynamically change the look and feel of projects, as well as applications, different tools, different components that we've added over time, and different parts that you can do inside the ignition screen builders there. This is an area of ignition that's gotten a lot of attention since the release of 8.1. And a few things that I'm going to highlight here. One of them is the equipment schedule component. This is a new component that existed inside Vision, but didn't exist inside Perspective. So we added that. It's a nice way to see things at a glance for what equipment might be running at different times. You can also use that for showing different people who are scheduled for different pieces. We added pipe drawing tools. That has been an oft-requested feature, and that's built right in. We added better locale support for numerical locales, so basically formats based on where you are around the world that dynamically change. If somebody ends up launching a client from Europe and then one from North America, you're going to see the number formats with commas and dots in opposite positions, and it's going to be the exact same numbers that are coming through. And of course, you'll be able to see that in your own locale in the right way. We added some better support for themes. There's a drop-down selector for that. We also added some mapping highlights. So there's a format called Geo JSON. We expanded that format support inside the map component, and that's going to be fun to show off. And we added a split container. This is a way of building out applications that this container allows for putting things side by side and letting a user choose what that split actually looks like. A user adjustable slider is part of that. And then one other highlight that's not in the visualization building tools, but it is in the visualization category in terms of being able to understand what's going on inside an ignition gateway, is we added a feature that we call our metrics dashboard there. It's a drag and drop of metrics. And rather than talk more about these, I'm going to turn this over to Matt for the first demo. We have four different demos that Matt's going to be doing here, and each one is going to be showing off a set of features. So Matt, over to you for the visualization demo here.
All right. So yeah, starting off right at the top there, the equipment schedule component. So this new component is just a standard Perspective component. You can drag right into the screen, and it gives you the ability to set up the different kinds of equipments or lines or anything else you're tracking just over time. Essentially, it's like a status chart plus Gantt chart, calendar, all in one. I'll give you a quick example of the interaction here. I can just select the range, and then that could end up creating an event. So I could even do that, say, for another one. I could come back to one here, select it, remove it. Ultimately, it fires off some various events for resizing, moving things, adding, deleting. So you have control over what you do with those events, where the data comes from. Could be a database, could be data set tags. It's really entirely up to you. So it's fully customizable in that way. The next example here is the pipes. So this pipes drawing tool is available in Perspective in the coordinate container here. So I've gone ahead and I've drawn an example using the pipes. The way this actually works here is I just brought out some simple components, some symbols here. And now when we switch to the actual pipe drawing mode at the top, you can see now there's some different anchors. I could click on any one of these anchors here and actually create the start of a pipe and then just begin drawing it. I could also take an existing pipe and size it, move a point, add a new point in the middle of it, even change things of how the pipe actually interacts. I can rotate it around. On top of all this, the pipes do have properties exposed. And because these are properties like any other, that means you can make them dynamic, bind them to something, change the color, change the look, the feel, all dynamically, even on the fly like that. So definitely a real powerful tool, real time saver when you need to draw out some kind of a flow, pipes or otherwise. It's also useful for things like electrical diagrams. You can just draw straight lines between all your various components there. So the next feature that we're highlighting here is the locales. So if I go in this example here, and I look at my chart that is running, what we've added is the ability to actually bring in that kind of locale information to one of your charts. So if you have some kind of, you know, range here on the axis, that's the traditional kind of English system here with comma separated digits and then a decimal point for the actual period for the decimal point. If I now switch that to something else, say German, it will actually swap that around, and you can see now the 55.81 versus the 10.000.00. That's the actual difference in the display here, as well as in the X trace as well. You can see the difference in the numerical format there. So this could be switched on the fly like that, which ultimately means the end user gets the look and feel that they are expecting. And a quick kind of note on that fourth topic that was mentioned, that update to the theming here, there's a nice handy drop-down selection right inside the designer. This works with not only the built-in themes, but of course, any custom provided theme that you want to create and supply yourself, use that with it as well. And using that, we can easily come back and actually test that out in the design interface. And then of course, come back, switch that over. So you don't have to manually type in the name of your theme. You don't have to necessarily remember that at all. So that's definitely a helpful tool right there. Moving right along, the Geo JSON feature that we mentioned. So traditionally, we did have some support for Geo JSON. That means you could come up to, you know, standard kind of Geo JSON tool, grab the example code required there, the values, and actually paste them into the map component in the Geo JSON layer. But we've added some additional kind of style objects to that, to where you can now even more fully feature, more customize those kinds of displays here. And again, because these are properties like any other, you could even bind to them to make them dynamic, make them highlight different areas. So definitely a lot of different options here that you can play around with. So that way you can get the kind of the effect that you're looking for your dynamic map system. And this new container that we mentioned, the split container, is actually pretty powerful. It sounds pretty simple. It's just two different objects that you can set up and then have the user actually select, you know, the sizing between them with an intuitive drag and set kind of interface here. But if you imagine, you could even nest these together, so that way the end user could actually get even more control. Not just simple, you know, left, right, but also the vertical here, we can adjust that. So again, certainly can do a whole lot more than what it may seem on the surface. So I'm definitely excited to see how customers take advantage of that. And this last feature is actually in the gateway webpage itself. So as mentioned, it's not part of the standard visualization tools you would use in the designer, but it is definitely a great visualization tool in itself. And it is available right inside standard, just Ignition web interface here. So under status, we can look at the metrics dashboard, and we can now start adding some kind of metric here. So this could be something as simple as, you know, what's the current CPU utilization. We could have the disk utilization and all these other points all in one go, where we can easily see that. And if we navigate away and then navigate back to it, of course, it can remember what's going on with that through the use of the saving feature here. So if there's any kind of dashboard that you want to actually keep using, you can actually just create it, save it, come back to it real quickly. That way you don't, of course, have to redraw this over and over. That's definitely something that we've thought about. So as you can see, I now have everything I need at a glance, and I can create multiples of these, save them, so you can easily, you know, just view what's the current status, or maybe compare different values instead of having to flip through the different status pages. And now, yeah, I can do that pretty quickly, pretty easily at a glance. But yeah, so that's the highlights of the different visualization features. So I'll turn it back over to you, Kevin.